And now, the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Good tech work, Lou. We had a whole thing prepared for him. Now it feels very disingenuous. You did your best. I was going to try to lament Dan Soder not being here. He's off filming Billions, doing what he has to do to feed his family. But everybody, Dan Soder's Gone. Paul Giamatti and that red-haired guy, I guess, is more important. What's his McFace? Damian Lemon.
Damian Lemon.
Comedian Damian Lemon, the star of Billions. Dan Soder's off, of course, filming Billions. So it's a week where we have some guest hosts, and this is a fun one. I'm double stacking. Fuck it. Why bring in one funny person when I can bring in two? Show favorites, everybody, sitting with us. Mike Fenoya and Shane Gillis.
Yeah, baby. Yes, let's fucking get it, dude.
Wow, can I say something? You were making jokes about what butt buddies Shane and Jacob are, because Jacob really loves being admired. It's all you have to say. I'll tell you, you could be the fattest woman in the world. You want to bed down Jacob? Really lay some compliments on him. But I said Mike Fenoya, and Jacob sat there stoic.
No.
And I said, and Shane Gillis, and, no. And Jacob did a weird little like clap, like almost so Mike wouldn't see over the computer.
Fuck you, Jacob.
Damn, dude. Damn.
Fuck it.
It's the bald thing, man. He's nervous.
That's what it is. He looks at you and sees himself.
Sees himself.
See my future.
And he's scared.
Yeah, man.
Your hair looks great.
Look at me.
Your hair looks great.
Look at me.
It's not going anywhere.
Yeah, it's going.
How long has it been since you shaved your
Jacob,
face?
Jacob, the beard's great. The beard's fantastic. I'm not lying to you at all.
Salt and pepper, bro.
The beard's fantastic.
Yeah, this is the first time I saw like the beard. The beard looks fucking nice,
yeah,
dude.
It's doing good.
How long
have
you been growing
it? A little bit longer.
How much longer?
Take that hair down, dude. You're gonna look like a bad motherfucker.
You got another month or so before you can even trim it.
Longer? Or?
Yeah, longer.
Yeah.
You can keep it out of your mouth and shit, but I mean, yeah, no. Let the length grow, dude. You're growing a beard. Then we're gonna shave that hair down low, buddy. Oh. You're gonna love it. You're gonna love it.
Well, I got the diversion on my face.
I bet if we get a fan to promise you
diversion.
Pussy if you do that. Huh? I bet we could find a fan that would promise you pussy if you do it.
I'm good.
Do you hate
every
that?
Time Jacob says that, he sees the girl and goes, oh, man, maybe I zigged when I should have zagged.
You know what? You're right. You caught me on that one.
Yeah.
I fucked up the last time.
Yeah. I'm like, Jacob, this girl
what
said
happened?
She wants to fuck you.
What happened?
A beautiful fan. Beautiful. Said she wanted to fuck Jacob. Jacob goes, I'm not going to do some arranged. I go, it's a fan, Jacob. She's not coming to be your girlfriend, but we were in Texas. I'm like,
I still think she was there mainly for you and Christine.
No, buddy, she said.
I'm not putting myself down.
No, you're not putting yourself down. I'm not saying,
I think that
yes,
was the case.
She would have fucked me and Christine. Absolutely. But she said, I'd like to fuck Jacob. Her words. And I tried to put you in touch. Jacob goes, I don't know. And I get it. I get the ego of it for sure. But she's a fan of the show. She's not doing it sight unseen. She knows what you look like.
It's not ego.
She's
it's
into
the
it.
Opposite. I just I'm like uncomfortable. I don't know.
It was an away game. You were in Texas.
She was so high. Perfect.
Yeah.
You don't have to bring her home to see your weird house. Do you have fucking compasses and nautical maps on the wall, you psycho?
Astrolabe.
I got nothing for you, Jay. I was wrong.
Your Vasco da Gama PJs.
A giant, which is a big captain's wheel up on the thing, netting. It looks like a fucking, it looks like an old seafood shanty.
If I knew she was coming over, I would have taken down all my Titanic shit.
Time to go to sleep where I'm a Viking.
But we could, I promise you, there's a fan that's attracted to you that would be like, yeah, if Jacob does that for the novelty of it, and it's a good excuse to break the ice on it, I'd fuck Jacob. Absolutely. 100%.
With this beard now, have you released?
Power of radio.
Have you released images of your new face?
No.
No, he's sure, not.
They're going to be
mean,
swarming.
Show.
Yeah,
the,
but yeah,
show
Lou,
videos.
Lou it captures good pictures, man. Yeah, for
he
sure.
Does.
Jacob, do you like having the beard? Some people hate having a beard. Do you like it?
I was never a beard guy. I'm getting used to it, though. And
I don't
know
life
I
without it.
It.
I haven't had facial hair since I can grow facial hair.
I can't.
Anything to cover my
you
stupid
can't
fucking.
Grow any.
My fat, dumb face. Anything I can do to like thin it out or cover it.
I wish I could.
It just doesn't grow?
Hide this hideous face.
It doesn't grow?
No.
Not
You'd
even
be
patchy?
A great beard guy.
Yeah, I'd look
I
great.
I can picture you you look like what guys who have crazy beards, like Duck Dynasty guys, shave that one day. You look like what's underneath
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. I feel like you would look like stage one Kris Kringle. Like, remember when he grew that beard, when it was like a big full red beard, like a young Santa?
But that's, you
thanks,
can't,
man.
It doesn't
grow.
Like
a young beard. Santa Claus?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
young I'll Santa show you Claus. The picture. It's a nice that full
was,
beard.
Mine was not meant to be insulting.
Neither did
the
mine.
The Santa Claus thing was weird.
Santa Claus is hurtful. What are you talking about?
Watch, I'll show you.
You look like no one ever sees you like Santa Claus. No, it's a compliment.
Oh, you spelled Kris Kringle with a K.
Oh, do you know you remind me of a ton? Ralphie May, but not in the bad ways.
That's not a bad beard.
All right, I appreciate it.
It's like an Irish fucking beard.
It's a good back pedal. Yeah, but you can't. It just doesn't grow.
Can't grow.
What's it look like? Have you ever tried?
No, it's like 12 long hairs. I look like an ancient Asian.
It doesn't come out.
Philosopher.
The hairs don't come out. It just gets like wispy.
Yeah, it's a nightmare. It's not good.
How can we see it? We have to try to make you do it. You have to try once. When's the last time you tried to grow a beard?
I've never tried to grow a beard.
Oh, and you shave.
It's that bad. Yeah.
You shave every day?
No. I can go like 4 days without shaving, and no one can really tell.
You have like blonde
just
hair.
Just have a gross mustache. I can grow a sick fucking
under
mustache.
And down here?
Yeah.
Nothing on the sides, though.
Not really.
Oh,
no.
Man.
Oh, you gotta try. I'd say try. You should document it on your show.
No.
You come back with your hair. He's got a hot girlfriend now. He doesn't want to do... by the way...
Yo, true.
Same thing. I'll tell you what...
Yo, true.
When you have a girlfriend, it's a time to actually do it, but I never want to do things. I couldn't be convinced. But if I was single and looking for ass at all, I don't know how much money you'd have to pay me to go shave your head and face... Like even just like a buzz cut, and take my facial
holy
hair
fuck,
off.
You'd be so funny looking.
It'd be a crazy amount of money.
Well, if you started losing your hair,
it would be something I could just buy hookers for the month, and that would not really dip into the money I thought I was profiting from.
Don't do that.
Yeah. Fucking playa. Cash
Yo,
money.
What up?
Cash rules everything around you.
Yo, also, shout out to all the listeners who thought I was black. Thank you.
On that,
no, for real,
shit.
That's so sick. That fucking, awesome. You know, Comedy Central did the videos.
Uh-huh.
The first one I was in,
sheets,
like,
yeah.
Three comments were like, wait, Shane Gillis is white? I was looking at the comments like, yo, fuck it.
That's great. You have good audiobook voice. So if you started losing your hair, Jay, you wouldn't shave it, you don't think? Would
no.
you fight it?
With everything, tooth and nail.
Get plugs.
Yeah, I'd try to do plugs if anything else. I don't know. I you know what?
I still want
to. I can't even process what that would have to be like because unless I have to get chemotherapy of some sort.
Yeah, you're good for.
I'm not going to lose my hair enough that I'll be like, this is a problem. I'm already 40. It's going, my dad's got a full head of hair.
Yeah, your dad's
got. It's like thin hair. But it's not thinning, you know what I mean? It's not like he has like a bald patch in the back. It's just like his hair is now much more like thin.
No, he's got 70s lineman hair. He's got Alex Karras head.
Yes, he does. He has Alex Karras, Webster's dad. George
Papadopoulos.
Of Georgian Ma'am. You never watch Webster? Mm-hmm. You're such a racist. Jacob, it's the one thing about you.
Jacob's racist?
I tried to get you...
That's why I tried
to get you laid in Texas. So you wouldn't scare the girl away with your racist views. I would never watch Webster, little monkey. She's like, ooh, that turned me on.
Hiding in the
do you remember
the laundry chute?
Black Lou, Lou, you guys remember the girl?
That's Jay's dad.
That is my dad.
The girl from Austin?
Yeah.
She's amazing.
Oh man, she was that good?
Good.
Well, here's what happened. So she came to say hi. I introduced Jacob. Jacob comes over with a hotsy totsy. Who was that? And he didn't say that. Meh. Jacob, I'm joking.
Meh.
You got to make a face. Like, it's not exactly how I said it. But he came over and he was like, who was that girl? I'm like, that was the girl that said, I'd love to fuck Jacob.
Did you tell her about all the cool boat stuff you have in your room?
No, I didn't get a chance.
You should have said that. You should be like, I have a bunch of cool boat stuff.
Periscope down.
I didn't even get to land on my wrap with her. I mean, it didn't even
really?
Get
nothing. No, he shook hands and just was like, wow, that girl's so beautiful. I'm like, that's the girl.
Were you cowboyed up? Were you wearing like boots and
no, they cowboy? Were.
You weren't at all. You were in your normal.
No, I had my hat.
Yeah, no, he
I did
good.
Have my cowboy hat.
Yeah,
you were wearing a cowboy hat?
Yes.
It's Austin.
God damn. Yeah.
And that didn't add to the confidence.
I
at
look
all.
Forward to wearing a cowboy hat when I go to Austin.
Oh yeah, he wears it the whole time.
Do you have a hat box that you check it?
No. We buy one every time we're down there. I'm bringing one. Now I got enough. Got a nice one the last time. I'm bringing that down.
Did we get you ever? Did we ever get him getting you a tight roll on the sides?
No, I got the. No, you picked out get, one that I want. I still got it.
You
got
to get. You got to get one of them. I want to get you a side roll one. You'll be a real badass.
I'm investing like in a like biker a JR Ewing yeah. one, man.
Like a peacock feather in the.
But look at him, though. I mean,
wow, that was
oh,
him.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
God damn.
Dude.
That's the way I want to be remembered.
I'll always remember you that way.
I mean, why don't you just do that? Why don't you just urban cowboy it? And
can we put that picture
out
again?
It doesn't play around here, Mike.
You don't you think guys? So?
No, you look like a you look somebody, like an asshole.
Somebody put this out again. And let's get some fans to Photoshop play with this. I'd like to see some knives on Jacob from his knife collection. A bolo tie, perhaps.
Maybe a beaver
very,
pelt.
Very, would be very happy to have that belt buckle enhanced
oh,
a bit.
Oh, man. And then the next one's, oh, you're. I thought you were wearing a fucking scarf. Yeah. I was like, oh, man. Really?
No, even more badass.
Back home.
It's no, that's when he had to wear a neck
Shane,
brace.
Shane, now you're looking at 2 weeks later. Quite a difference.
Yeah, the weight of that fucking cowboy hat maybe, broke your fucking pencil neck.
Maybe Austin's just the place for you, you know? Maybe New York just isn't.
What I don't like about Austin is they're I think that's one of the my
all
favorite
the Mexicans?
Cities. They're snobs about their anti-cowboy hat. They're too progressive. Meaning, but in my view, it's the greatest hat ever made. They should take back the hat.
There you
cowboy
go.
Cowboy hats get a bad rap because I think like some of the stupidest things ever said have been said while wearing one. But
why?
The hat itself is brilliant. Everyone looks good wearing one.
That's not true. That's at
I do
not
think true. It's true.
Not everybody looks good wearing one.
I would look like a Make-A-Wish kid wearing a cowboy hat.
Yeah,
Mike would look.
I can't.
No, you know
gotta
what,
get the right hat for you. We went to the store. It's a matter
Mike,
of finding the right.
He's right. You could wear a black hat. I see you with a black hat, a silky black Western shirt, but all black fringe.
Jesus Christ!
Black pants.
No,
that's the cowboy you are, buddy. No, Mike,
just a
that's
gay,
the cowboy
a gay
you
dancer.
Are. And you carry around a deck of cards where it's just the there's just the like the pictures on them. There's no numbers.
Yeah,
like the six of hearts is just six hearts. An old westerny kind of deck of cards.
A hand rolled cigar.
I think I've seen what I look like as a cowboy. There's a fat guy on Bonanza.
The new Bonanza?
No, the old one. Right.
And they say that's what you look like
as a
cowboy.
Yeah. I wish I could get some help on that.
The hat
black loophole.
Instead of people just
black loopholes it off great.
He looked fantastic.
Black loopholes
everyone
it off
got
real
the
nice.
Right hat for themselves.
Is it a heavy hat, Jacob? I don't think I've ever worn a cowboy hat.
No. I mean, in the summer you wear a straw hat and then you wear
that's
a...
That's great.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I would look
Hawks.
Like.
And he's right. It's not bad.
No, you're right.
It's not he's good. Pulling it up. It's not good.
No,
did you wear one?
You
got
to go
there?
To the store with us, Shane, and get the right
no,
hat.
I would never wear that. I'm from fucking New Jersey.
You wouldn't wear a cowboy hat ever?
No, it's stupid as hell.
All right.
Why would I want to be
so
a cowboy?
Jacob,
I'm not a cowboy.
I know how to lure you guys, though.
You look
right.
good wearing one.
Next
you
time
would.
We go to Moon Tower,
where,
though,
on the
if
range?
You wear a cowboy
where
hat
I look
the whole
good
time.
At that?
If we have a girl, if we have a girl give you pussy in Austin, Texas, will you wear a hat the entire time?
While she's giving me pussy.
No,
only.
No.
While she's giving me pussy.
Once the pussy stops
at,
being
at
given, the
pussy
hat
party.
Comes off.
That was a harsh way to put it.
Yeah.
When you give me pussy, you'll get the hat.
Only at the pussy party, cowgirl.
Jesus H, Lou.
What? I really am against it. I don't... We're not
you
that culture.
Even try it on.
You grew
you
up in New Jersey. All right, I hate fighting Jacob.
What do you think's going to happen?
You guys should fight.
I don't want to fight with him anymore, and I feel I want to make an apology. I was really joking yesterday on the air, and I realized he took offense to it. And
damn, he
was
just
mad
called
at
you
me
a sensitive
for the
pussy.
The,
all right, no, I
but
accept
I was out of line.
No, no need to say it,
things.
Jacob. No need to say it. It's fine.
Well, I hope you believe me because
I do, cowboy.
You guys
call me that, then I appreciate it.
Look at you guys making
I think
up.
You guys should do 10 paces and draw.
Do you think Dan's the bad energy? You think maybe under the radar Dan's been the bad energy the whole time? Is that why everyone's breaking into war all the time? Look at everybody kissing and making up while we're here. This is so beautiful.
Like
huh?
I don't want to fight.
What were you guys fighting about? What were you fighting about?
I was coughing on Jacob, and he doesn't like germs.
Yeah, he
so
coughs
ends.
Too much, right?
Yeah, and I'm a germaphobe, and we're in the room.
And yeah, you gotta tell him
the,
to stop coughing.
We're locked in the room. He can't do what he's stopped doing, and I can't.
You didn't get your big friend Shane after me? You getting your big pal, your bodyguard? Is that your bodyguard?
Oh, my God, they look like my bodyguard.
Yes!
Remember?
Yes!
Remember that movie, My Bodyguard?
I love it.
Movie.
Adam Baldwin.
Yeah, Adam Baldwin.
That makes me Matt Dillon.
I like that. Shit, Shane's got to walk
so much
Jacob.
Cooler.
All right, Shane, you want to come by? I'm about to go out to lunch. I don't want to eat any shit.
You know how fucking old I am? Saw it in the theater.
Oh, yeah, you did.
Oh, yeah, you did. Look at Shane and Jacob. There they go.
DJ Matt Dillon.
I'll take that, man.
Oh, my God. Look at all that hair, too,
that's
Jacob.
So great.
You tough, Jacob. You fucking pussy.
Listen Damn you, here. Moody.
Listen here. Listen here, Don Wicklin. You bitch.
That's so great. I love it.
My bodyguard.
But Shane, you said you weren't. Were you like you were a bully? I forget last time you heard me talk about that.
Yeah, I was a bully.
Yeah.
Well, I would just, you know, call kids gay. Push them. Classic bully shit.
I feel like that's exactly how bully you got your 23-year-old girlfriend now.
Oh, for sure.
You just saw her. She goes, I don't know. Like, I'm only 23. And you go, you hate this guy? Faggot.
Yep.
She's like, I don't know. I mean,
I guess
maybe.
Now. If you want to give me a ride home, I guess.
I guess so.
Yeah, I bullied. Bullying's fucking sick. Shout out to all the fucking bullies, dude. Keep bullying. Fuck those pussies. It's not your fault they can't take a joke. Kill it, dude.
Well, I did. I used to argue a lot when they had all those anti-bullying campaigns.
He loves you so much.
He loves you so much.
And I got the
love.
Shit kicked out of me by bullies.
Yeah, but now you're friends with a bully. Now
yeah.
It's good.
Love it.
Now you got
this
one.
So beautiful.
Now you got
man.
One on your side.
I love it.
Next time he coughs, I'll give him a fucking swirly.
Yeah, swirly.
Tell you best friend. That is I used to argue a lot when all the anti-bullying campaign. Mike used to go shuck and jive at schools telling that story.
Yeah, we bullied each other just for like sports and shit. We did a lot of hate.
Yeah, yeah.
No,
yeah,
but I got
but
bullied a little
really
bit. I'm sure I've bullied somebody in my life. But my thing is, I think, and I'm not saying you should be a bully. I'd be mortified if my kid was the bully in something or whatever. You know.
Yeah.
And I never intentionally went out to bully someone with that mindset, but. I think there's a place in the ecosystem for bullies. I think it teaches you something.
Absolutely.
Like when I stuck up to somebody who I was nervous that was coming at me, when I stuck up to somebody for myself, like that was like, that's a thing. Jacob, you remember? Remember you fucking gave a two-piece to that fucking guy at the restaurant?
Yeah.
Yeah, it changed the whole, turned his world around.
You fucking beat up a dude?
Dude, guy freaked out after he saw blood.
And what's best is Jacob told him, he goes, in 5 hours when we're off this shift, I'm going to fuck you up.
It's
and then
great.
They completed
what?
Their shift.
Yeah.
Full
I'll see after.
The biggest
I'll see after shift.
It, man. That's fucking great.
Oh, my
great.
God. Hey, man, can you cover my fucking table? I'm going to go for a smoke. Hey,
bizarre.
Piece of shit.
Where and when was this?
Was it our French bistro?
I figured it was Madison Avenue.
The most neutral place.
Take his knees out with a baguette.
Madison Avenue.
When did you graduate, Shane?
High school? 2006.
Yeah. Oh, wow, okay.
You bummed out because now you know he's so young?
Well, no, I was just thinking I graduated like almost 10 years before that. And I was thinking about bullying.
I graduated 11 years before that.
You were pre-Columbine, so bullying was...
Cool.
People still respected a good bullying.
Yeah, but if you were a piece of shit about it, other people would bully him.
Yeah,
bully,
of course.
You know what
of course.
I mean?
I didn't actually bully. Like, I wasn't, like, fucking with kids that
no, like
actually
a shit
had
talk.
Problems.
Like, you know, it's
yeah,
like,
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Right.
Fucking
be like, ball busting.
Yes.
Yeah.
But that is bullying now.
It is.
Yep.
For sure it's called bullying. We used to ball bust all the time, but we did have that. We said my friend Benji had a rough go. First of all, his name was Benji.
Mm-hmm.
Ginger kid, heavy set.
I would have been all over that.
Short. Rough go. A bit of a rough go as far as that goes. And we'd bust his balls as much as anybody. But if somebody like externally came at him a little bit, you gotta be like, why?
That's our guy.
It's like, you gotta be nice to Benji first before you bust his ball. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
you have
exactly.
to be cool with him before you could shit on him like that.
We had a kid on our football team, Carlos, that never played, and he was fucking, would pick on everybody smaller and younger in school. And one time he like nailed a kid's jacket to the wood shop table. And the kid was just so small and sad, and he had nothing, he couldn't do anything about it. So the rest of us just went and fucking nailed Carlos's shit to the woodshop table, and
hell
we're
yeah.
like, what the fuck are you going to do now?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
And then we flew away. Down
vigilante
the hall.
Amigo.
The low-risk vigilante, man. I didn't like when people got picked on because they were little. That's the only thing I got
in the face of, what was it, Tom Cotter, Tom Van Horn, and some other fucking old comic strip comic when I was young and went there. They took... I didn't know them at all. These are like, haven't spoken words to these guys really anywhere yet. And they took my wallet chain thing off and clipped it to like... the velvet rope thing and nothing happened
because
I just felt it happening, so I turned around, just looked and unhooked it, so I didn't like pull anything down, But I just, like, immediately, something like that, like, I went to him, so, and I'm not a confrontational person, but that was already, I was like, you're trying to make me look like an asshole. They were hoping I'd walk away and yank the thing down. And I got in three old men's faces.
Yeah, those dudes, too, of all fucking...
By the way, funny to call them old men now. I was probably 23, and they were my age now. These old dudes.
Tom Connors.
Now I'm like, I wish one of these 23-year-old comics would say something. I'll drop his ass.
That's so fucking weird. Tom Cotter being a bully. And it wasn't even... He loses to Poodles on America's Got Talent.
Could you imagine? That was right. Second place to Poodles.
Damn, he lost to Poodles. Are good show dogs, though.
Yeah. Loss, if I'm going to Vegas, I want to see Poodles over Tom Cotter for sure. Yeah.
I don't know what the hell half those people they put in America's Got Talent are going to do in Vegas when they show some of them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like one person who does like fire juggling, and that's like the one thing he does.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
You're going to go to an hour and a half long fire juggling show of this guy?
The Poodles are wearing clothes and dancing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a fucking tough act to follow.
Yeah, what are you going to do? Tell jokes after that? Like an asshole? Look at them. They know how to go over the bar, and they go under the bar. They go up on the stool, they jump off the stool.
These are good dogs.
They sit.
Tom Cotter couldn't do that if you gave him 8 tries.
Cotter got fucking buried by these dogs.
Yeah, he really did.
That's a fucking bummer.
Yo, did you ever see it? Yo, Cotter got massacred by these fucking animals.
Oh, that dog even fucked up and Cotter lost to him.
Oh, man. And Cotter, they say that night, flawless.
10 out of 10. Nailed every landing.
100%. I've actually hung out with Tom Cotter so much since that incident
nice
when I was older. Yeah, I actually like Tom very much.
It would suck to have the best set of your life and be like, damn, I definitely got through. And then they're like, up next, Poodles. You stand there like they hit early and you're like, all right, they'll cool off.
A guy who gets kicked in the nuts a whole bunch.
Dog's doing backflips.
This dog just levitates. It's like, how do you beat a fucking floating dog?
Yeah, it's bad enough when you have to watch other comics on a monitor and say they're doing better than me in something.
Yeah, it's just
adorable
just there
and watch, like, shit. Like, seriously, like angels running around on Howard Stern. How are you going to fucking lose? That's why I'm glad that girl lost the singer. The 14-year-old singer.
Well, because what was she going
to
do in
Vegas?
Well,
if she went to Vegas, she would have been smacked out on the street like in 3 weeks.
Yeah.
There's nothing a 14-year-old girl.
She's
Wait,
so young.
She was a 14-year-old girl singer?
Yeah.
I sounded bet, like
was she hot?
Yeah.
She definitely was hot.
but she's hot.
So
in,
talented too.
Not in like
this
pop
is
star.
Gross. Wait a second. I've never seen her. It was just a guess.
Yeah, not all pop right. star hot. She's well, I should say she's very pretty.
Wait,
she's
14.
Pretty,
that girl's 14. She's wearing a pantsuit.
She's gonna be very pretty. Yeah, for
if you're
sure.
You're wearing a pantsuit. You're of age. You're qualified. <That's good. laughs> Oh man, this girl's young as fuck, dude. This is not hot, dude. You guys are wrong.
You can't judge on
you said she was
a
kid.
You said she was hot.
Oh, he asked if she was hot, and I was like, in the context of what he's saying, yes.
But look, then she loses the jacket.
You're like, come on, man, she is hot.
No, dude, you got to see when the jacket comes off. Then,
come on,
pew.
See those moves too. Oh,
she takes it too.
She will be hot. She is not hot right now.
Yeah, I go.
But she's primed up.
She is in her prime. She's in her prime.
Dude, she's so talented. Yeah, but she lost. But she should have lost.
Yeah.
We were watching when we'll take our first break here in a second. When we come back, we should.
We got to find.
Mike
those.
Was in the room with me watching. In my whole of American Idol auditions gone haywire.
Holy shit, it was
like
hilarious.
The old ones.
Oh man,
just finding some of those gems where the gay guy we still have to do
the black dude,
the bitchy lady. I gotta find that black dude who tries to sing
the
whole
guy,
way out.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about, the gay dude. He's hilarious.
You'll love this dude. This guy in Philly will be tied to the back of an ATV.
I'm excited.
We're hanging out with Mike Fenoy, Shane Gillis. It's the Bonfire. Yeah, take that beat for a walk, Lou. Have you ever spent a night on 100% organic cotton sheets? If you have, you've probably never slept better in your whole life. Well, Ball & Branch makes the softest, most comfortable 100% organic sheets you will ever sleep on. And because they only sell them online at BallAndBranch.com, their sheets cost less than half of the designer brands and are twice the quality. Hundreds of thousands of Americans love Ball & Branch sheets, including 3 U.S. presidents. You won't believe how comfortable 100% organic cotton sheets can feel until you try Ball & Branch. But don't just take their word for it. You can sleep on Boll & Branch sheets risk-free for 1 month. And if they're not the most comfortable sheets you've ever slept on, you can send them back for a full refund. Plus, if you order right now, you'll get $50 off your first set of sheets, plus free shipping. With BollAndBranch.com promo code Bonfire. That's spelled B-O-L-L and Branch.com promo code Bonfire. BollAndBranch.com promo code Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Fucking hilarious, man. You got to go see both of these guys live. But I know you said it was sort of like you're going up there this weekend just to do the one-nighter. So, yeah, show your love, campers. Make sure you come out and represent. Let Shane know you're there. Let Shane know you saw him on the Bonfire, heard him on the Bonfire, and come laugh with him. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah,
if you want to hear my shit, I'll be fucking...
Oh, my bad.
No, no worries. What were you going to say?
I was just going to say I'll be with Soder... in New Mexico and Arizona.
Fuck
also.
Yeah.
So that'll be fun, yeah.
Hell yeah, dude.
Yeah.
And Southwest then, tour.
Southwest. I'm going to be this weekend, if you're listening live, Calgary, Canada at Yuck Yucks, Calgary. Come check me out there. Friday and Saturday, two shows each night, I believe. And Edmonton, a couple weeks after that. I've got House of Comedy in Minneapolis, all kinds of fun stuff. BigJComedy.com for all my dates. And, of course, follow us at The Bonfire, SXM, on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook Campers Group, all that shit. We were watching, I was trying to find these and cue these up during the break.
Fun
these American Idol auditions.
Casino.
Just sitting there. The casino in general was just a goddamn...
It's the fucking worst.
It really feels like you're dying for 3 days. 3 days, you die of the year a little bit more than you do every other day.
It's the fucking worst.
Just being in a casino...
The last time I was in a casino was for the Foxhole Celebrity Weekend. So it's
what?
Been a while.
The Foxhole Jamie Foxx's Celebrity Weekend?
You were there?
Yeah, I mean,
did you wear a cowboy hat?
The fuck were you doing there? How do you lack swagger and you roll deep in Jamie Foxx's entourage?
Hole.
Well, I was producing.
You were in Jamie Foxx's hole.
You were in his hole, dude.
What casino?
It was Atlantic City. I can't remember the name of the casino. I can't remember which casino.
Oh, they blindfold you?
Yeah, really.
You too doped up? What happened, Jacob?
Nothing. I saw Megan Good there.
And?
Nothing happened. Lou, would she be on your top 10? Megan Good.
Top 15, definitely not. Top 15.
God.
Top 10 black chicks?
Something wrong with
you. Know Lou's a connoisseur.
Yeah, Megan Good.
You gotta be creaming the crop for him.
Megan's average.
You know his things.
What?
He likes Rihanna, Shirley Hemphill, TV's What's Happening, Shirley?
The Girlfriend from a Different World.
The Girlfriend from a Different World. Jaleesa.
Damn.
Jaleesa from a Different World. Florida Evans.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jake.
Damn, dude, I've never even heard of one of these people. These people, my bad.
It's those people, Shane.
Yeah, yeah. Get
your head out of your ass. Can't take the Philly out of this guy. It's those people.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, those people over there.
I've never heard of none of these black chicks. None of them.
I had a friend that would say that sentence a lot. She's really hot for a black chick. And it never reads good when you say that.
No.
I even know it's not meant racist. No one's ever said that meaning it racist. Well, I said, I don't know about
it
that.
It definitely is.
It's most racist thing.
But it comes off so racist. Hot for a black chick?
Yeah, it's like black girls aren't pretty, but she's pretty.
Well, it's like on the ranking system that starts significantly lower for black chicks. For a black chick, they're top of the heap. Almost hit the white scale.
Jesus.
It is a weird, but my friend Mikey, when I was younger, used to always say that. It always hit us. Every time he said it, he goes, I mean, she's just hot. I mean, I get what you're saying. I get what you're saying. You know what I mean? Like, I get, like, we weren't in a crew of friends that were, like, pulling black chicks all the time. You know what I mean? Yeah. So it was kind of out of our.
Asian dudes still get it.
What do you mean?
Asian dudes are, like, the last race that still get hit with that pretty hard.
Oh, it's an
like
Asian.
If you're like a handsome dude, you're like, he's actually pretty hot for an Asian dude.
Oh, yeah. Without a doubt. You wouldn't even think about
it. And Indian dudes?
They're such a cold. Asians are such
a
cold.
I see a handsome Indian. I'm like, damn, look at that guy.
Oh, yeah.
I would see one of those.
Look at that Indian. He's handsome.
Asia is such a cold culture that when they're, like, attractive, it doesn't even affect them. They don't even complain they get called a good-looking Asian dude. They would never even think of them to complain it. To complain about that, they're too busy practicing the cheated blackjack
or
something.
Zeros and ones and shit.
get a bunch of 4-year-olds and put them in. in a starter jacket factory.
Yo, bring up a hot Asian. Let me see some of these hot Asian dudes.
Oh, yeah, he's not Asian.
Oh, yeah, Mohinder from Heroes?
He looks like MJ from Thriller.
He looks like Stamos.
That's not a good-looking Asian dude.
What did you just look up good-looking Asians on Instagram?
21 fine-as-hell Asian men who will make you swoon and then some.
She only had to type in 21, though, damn. And everything else fills in. She looks it up all the time. This is what she blasts to, and I'm gone. That guy's not Asian. Now they're using a very loose interpretation of the word Asian.
We saw the armpit of every race at the casino. The casino Asians are just...
Oh, man.
Casino Asians?
My still God, dude.
Everyone still has the bowl haircut. It's great.
It's sick.
Chuck Negron playing in the Wolf Den for free.
Everybody walking around with free Tupperware. It was like a bad nightmare.
But we gambled,
and I had fun gambling. We did
have a good time gambling.
We hit blackjack.
But we went up to the room at points, and we're watching these American Idol auditions, and I just forgot how funny it is. Not the ones that were over the top. There's a couple of those, like the William Hung that just came in. But people then genuinely believe they had something going on. Yep. Like the ones that are just left of good. Do you know what I mean? They're not bad. People got good, and they are just like there. And those people that are delusional and they snap, we have, this is the blonde girl, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think this is a good example of what I'm talking about.
Your name is...
Mary Roach. However, if I do make it to Hollywood, I'm going to change my last name to Gilbo because it has more star quality.
Okay, right there.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. You're like, well, I'm dealing with someone who's batshit immediately.
She's already talking, changing her name and shit.
Yeah.
She's dressed like fucking Gilligan.
She got Cindy Brady head and Gilligan body.
Yeah, this isn't good.
She looks like a Tom Petty Live 1972 video.
That's right.
It's like Todd Rundgren.
She looks like the drawing of Tom Petty in Running Down a Dream.
It really did.
YLBEAUX.
What do you do?
Well, I plan on going to cosmetology school at the end of the month. Unless I make it to Hollywood, then I'm going to cancel my
If you're listening, how many guesses would it take for you to know this bitch is wearing a hemp necklace?
You can hear it.
I would much rather have a singing career than a hairstyling career, even though I very much love hair, makeup, and fashion as well.
And why are you here?
I'm here because...
Make an ass of myself.
I'm just like a backup skateboarder in Gleaming the Cube.
She has Johnny Lawrence hair.
She really does.
Got Owen Wilson.
Yeah.
To a T.
And it's been my all-time dream for a long time to become a big, famous singer and performer. And this is just one way to do it if I make it.
What are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing...
Nothing like telling the judges that it goes singing, dancing... Stand up acting. I don't give a shit. I'm making it in something. That's how good I am. Every time I'm focused on a thing at all, like I have no passion. Whatever's going to make me $1 million and not have to work is fine. You guys call it. What do you want me to do? You want me to do remake of Norma Jean? You want me to be the star of that?
I'm pretty talented for a white chick.
Carol King.
All right, off you go.
I feel the earth move.
Killing it.
Bottom of the sky can fall down. I feel
Let me stop you there. You're through.
This is the worst thing I've ever seen.
It's always the worst. I forgot
Everyone's
what a piece of shit Paula Abdul was because she was just ripped.
Dude, she's ripping Hollywood. She was all Xanax on so every commercial break.
Unless you are fantastic and she gets the vibe from everyone around her that they're enjoying it, if God forbid it's just not out of the gates great, she's already right away like a bitch, like rolling her eyes, like, why am I here? And that's everyone's asking that. Why is Paula Abdul here? Let's hear Paula Abdul acapella it straight up.
Damn, though. Imagine taking drugs like that and then having to sit through like 1,000 fucking people.
It sounds like a blast.
Real fucked up.
That'd be great.
Tell me a better way to do it. Yes.
Take some painkillers, watch some people fail.
Can you give me Oxycontin right now? I'll watch 4,000 auditions of bad singing.
Go down to Kensington.
Just gack a bunch of them.
Hit the fucking Kensington. You'll see those people strutting around. She's still singing. She's down there.
Look at her. She's camel toe.
When I see your face mellow as the month of May, I can stand it when you look at me that way.
Dark Depressed Night.
She's got back of a bike voice.
Dark Depressed Night. How many songs can you make it through telling her she's good if you think she's going to fuck you at the end of it?
Oh, man. That'd be tough.
I'm saying it's a depressed night. You're like, I need something to take my mind off of other bad shit. How many songs? How many songs do you go, that's good, it's good. You want to hear another? I goes, I could do one more.
For sure.
I could do one more.
One, dude.
Yeah, this is...
When you're near me, and you tenderly call my name.
I could do four.
I know.
Why is
Pardon me, Rhapsody.
Pardon me, Dennis the Menace, is it?
That was.
When they're like, you don't know what to say because you've never seen anything that great before, they mean it.
What do you think you did?
How do you think you did?
Not too shabby.
Yeah. I love
you. Like, out of 1 to 10.
That's every time I have sex with a girl. How do you think you did? Not too shabby. I think I did all right.
What I'm working with, I think I did pretty good.
Not too shabby.
Thoughts out of 10?
Like, out of 1 to 10 scale, how do you think I did? 8?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
Pretty good. All right, Mary.
Mark McGrath.
I would have said 10. Yeah.
A 12.
One of the worst I've ever heard in my life.
The worst?
Yeah. Honestly.
I mean, I've heard...
Are you just saying that to get on my nerves, or are you totally serious? Because something tells me that I think you're saying it to annoy me.
Yeah.
She's not wrong.
What made you audition for this competition?
All my friends told me that I was an awesome singer.
I've heard babies
Mary,
die.
You can't sing a note. I mean, not only can you not sing a note in tune, you have one of the weirdest voices I've ever heard in my life.
Well, weirdness is originality, too.
Right?
Yeah, she's been told that her whole life.
When you see this one, you can stop her. I'm telling you, when you see, she just keeps telling Mark McGrath he's hot. When you see the one that tries to pitch the idea that I can be the first American Idol who doesn't even sing. And melt, it falls apart, starts crying. She's going through some other shit. That girl there.
Oh, this chick is fucking.
I only got her. I got her.
That shit. Crazy.
I got her and the gay kid.
And you don't.
And the black guy are the three.
Yeah, the best.
So which
this girl is.
You do her first.
This is like a Saturday Night Live fucking skit, man.
Yeah.
She's out of her goddamn mind.
It's next level crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, look, Jacob, everyone does look good in a cowboy hat.
Maybe if she kept it on, she would have made
Sarah
it through.
Goldberg. How are you?
I'm good.
You're 20?
Yes. I am 20 years old.
So what do you sing?
Selena, Dreaming of You.
I'm 4
Whenever
songs
you're ready.
I no longer need this.
You didn't even need to hear her sing.
Nah. I could get through
I'd ask her for a fifth.
I'd get through an album.
Yeah.
I could sit through an album for this one.
She's cute.
Late at night when all the world is sleeping, I stay up and think of you.
That's the song she sings when you fall asleep.
And I wish on a star that somewhere you are.
Man, how quick can you get out of there?
I mean, so we're doing it one day. Pause it. There you go. It's good. That's really, you're doing something there.
Man, whatever
you're doing something there, girl.
Can we stop?
American Idol goes, well, don't blow your voice. When are the auditions coming up? Are they coming up soon?
You want some hot honey? You want some honey, baby?
You want some,
want some hot water and honey?
Women of you tonight till tomorrow, I'll be holding you tight.
Yeah.
And there's nowhere in the world I'd rather be.
She got
than
good
here
energy,
in
though.
My
She's happy.
Dreaming
I would have put her through, dog.
You and me.
She practiced in her mirror with blood
That's
rolling down her neck.
Yeah, dude. Some Jew in a cowboy hat. Smiling, I'd be like, "Yeah, you're in.
Yeah, you're fine.
You're gonna run Hollywood anyway. Get in here.
Here's the easy pass. Look at this fucking.
No, but you and me.
Can I ask you a question? Do you, in your heart, really think you can sing?
No.
She said no.
Really yes. Look at that Good. Psycho.
So why are you here?
Joan Collins?
No,
I'm
it's
not.
I thought it was
oh.
too.
Oh. Yeah.
Wow.
We
you're
that
standing
out.
There shaking your head the
Couldn't
entire time.
That
I'm
out.
Melting. You are, Paula, you're looking at him and you're laughing at me.
No, I'm looking at him and I'm laughing with
you. So you came because you wanted to be on TV.
I mean, you were laughing.
Xanax is an amazing
zipped. I goes, baby, I'm laughing with you. I'm laughing at whatever you want to say. I'm laughing at, can you just go away?
I am now going to get all emotional.
Damn.
I'm not a singer.
No, we got that.
You know, I really love to sing. I really do. And my friends make fun of me all the time because I'm tone deaf.
You have no friends.
But, shut up.
Yeah, well.
Shut up.
It's true.
Shut up.
Shut up.
Shut up.
I hear you
say shut up.
Okay.
See?
Fair.
Even if I don't sing, I can be the next American Idol.
Why?
And you want to know why?
Yeah, I love to know why.
You want
to
know why?
Yeah.
You motherfucking want to know why?
Because I've never sung before. And so you can teach me how to sing.
Oh, yes. Fuck.
I think I practice. I practice with, like, music. I can't believe I'm crying this much.
She wants to practice singing with music.
I think you don't have to sing to be an American Idol. I really don't.
That's a nice message.
I think Paris Hilton can't really sing.
I mean, she's kind of wrong.
Who said she could?
I'm actually aware of that. I know that you don't realize it, but I
think I don't know what you're thinking
here.
Before you're going to say it.
But I've seen that meltdown in life before. Someone who just, you're not arguing with them, but they're going through every emotion in their head. You know, goes, and I just think I'm having so much fun that I don't want to leave. My work sucks. Everyone hates me there. You're like, wait, what's going on? You want to sing another song again, stupid? Yes, and I'm dreaming. Well, watch when she goes out to the hall. She leaves.
Oh, it's not the beginning. That's pretty obvious.
Well, at least she's not harboring any resentment towards the judges.
It's absolutely rude. Like, you are people. We are people, too. Just because we don't have $1 million and we don't have singing deals doesn't mean that we don't have lives and doesn't mean that we don't have important things in our lives.
This is my favorite part.
Day-to-day.
I have become friends with these guys. I have become friends with Ray and Jen and Bill the security guy because I have been here forever. And you know what?
What's this bitch saying?
Do I bet Bill went home that night and was like, this lunatic, or that, or Bill got his dick sucked outside the parking lot.
Yeah, we are friends.
Oh, yeah, baby
like,
girl, come on.
What's up, baby?
I listen to you sing your goofy shit. Yeah, sing your shit, bitch.
Night drinking in New York City until 3 o'clock in the morning, and that is rude.
She says she's mad because the judges went out drinking the night before
until three.
They couldn't possibly see talent. Yeah, I know. We have a guest coming in. I know pretty soon. So let's go through these. This is the gay guy who.
Hi, how you been?
Oh, this guy is amazing.
Hello, how are you?
Good.
How are you?
What's your name?
My name is Ian Benardo.
This is my favorite kind of gay person.
How old are you? I am 25 years old, Mr. Cowell.
All right, and why are you here?
They're not mad at you because you don't like them because they're gay. They're mad at you because you're not gay. It's a different kind of anger. Because you're like, I'm fine with gays. And he goes, I bet you are, asshole. He's like that kind of guy.
Yeah, gay guys are deceptively mean.
Yeah, oh yeah.
You know what I mean, that's something a lot of people don't talk about is how mean gay dudes are.
I've been to tell a lot of gay dudes like, you're not a girl, dude. I'll knock you out and tell everybody I knocked out a man.
Good.
That's like, why else would I be an American Idol? I'm here to be the next American Idol. I thought that it would be a nice addition to my already long and impressive resume.
Which is
superstar, dancer, singer.
It's his resume, it's superstar.
And this is Chilla, and I'm wearing it specifically to show the world how wealthy I can be.
Well, you're not a superstar.
It's cool, American Idol did that
the
first couple, like, every season they would just be like, here's a couple retarded people we filmed.
And
here we're going to humiliate these retarded
people. And they stopped.
And then we'll get to some singing.
And they just stopped.
They kind of needed to stop. That's the right thing to do. This is real fucked up.
This guy's not retarded.
This guy's obviously fucked up.
I don't know. He's just gay.
No,
he's New York.
No, he's like a piece of shit guy. Gay dude.
He's just been told he's great his whole life.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's got a mom that he still sleeps in bed with.
He needed some bullies.
Yes. Yeah.
A bully would have helped him a lot.
A bully would have helped this kid.
I should have just gave him one dead arm and be like, dude, you're fucking gay. Stop fucking trying to sing, dude. Fucking
take a t-shirt with your name on it off.
Yeah. You're not a fucking superstar.
I like no homophobia. He goes, just suck dick and take in the butt, man.
That's it.
What's the problem? Just do that. Stop trying to make everyone tell me you're a superstar.
Don't make me
singer
fucking
dancer.
Feel bad, dude. Just be gay.
Stop throwing pageants at lunch.
Stop throwing lunch pageants.
I'm sick of your lunch pageants. All right, you win every time.
Go play it.
Superstar, but you may be a singer and a dancer.
I am a singer, I'm a dancer, and I am a superstar. You can ask my family, you can ask my friend, you can ask one of my therapists.
One of my therapists.
One of them. How many therapists do you have?
I have two.
All right, okay. What are you going to say?
Gloria. Gloria, you're always on the run now, running after somebody. You're gonna get him somehow.
You don't think this guy's retarded?
No.
This guy is retarded.
Crank it.
I know I'm not supposed to be saying that.
So be careful not to show it. You really don't remember. Was it something that he said? Are the voices in your head calling Gloria? Gloria, don't you think you're falling? If everybody wants you, why isn't anybody calling?
You don't have to answer. Leave him hanging on the line. Hey, hey, hey.
Gloria. What are you going to go somewhere?
That's Cardi B. I think she trans.
You meet him on the main line.
Okay. Inbreeding.
On the rebound.
Okay.
All right, I would give him 2 seconds.
I was just going to go, stop.
He could for sure be inbred.
Leave him hanging on the phone, blah, 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 hello, Gloria.
I think it was due to some Jewish inbreeding.
Wait, go to the...
some inbreeding.
Some classic Jewish inbreeding.
Some classic Jewish
Jacob, you
inbreeding.
Like that shit? Oh, yeah. That's a cowboy hat and you're coming right out.
Main line, okay. Or will you catch him on the rebound? Will you marry for...
Okay.
This guy's got moves, though. He's got some sexuality.
Oh, God, dude, I don't even know what to say.
Thank you.
That's the best. I don't know what to say.
I know. Yeah, I know.
Yeah. He goes, I get that a lot.
My therapist doesn't either.
By the way, he did not nail the song.
I mean,
Gloria.
Gloria.
I heard you on the rebound.
Keep
Gloria.
You hanging on the line, ho, pulling Gloria.
How you doing? Blah, 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 Gloria.
I love it when a guy compliments my vibe.
Yeah. Goddamn right.
Damn right.
I love Lewitsky.
Was it something that he said?
Yeah, we'll take the break. We'll come back with the guy who sings his way out when we have our guest. Why not? A special guest who I just found out was in town today, and it was cool enough to get him to come down. And, no, he was cool enough to come down. I said I was cool enough to get him to come down.
That's got to be your pull.
You're welcome, everybody.
You're pretty cool, dude.
My good friend, retired NFL tight end and a fucking a beast on the field and a great buddy, Dustin Kell, everybody.
Yeah.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Put your headphones on. You can hear all the fun stuff that Lou does.
This is how it works.
It's good to see you, man.
It's good to be here. It's good to be in New York.
You live in Austin, Texas now.
I do.
It's funny, Shane asked me before how I met you, and I go, I'll actually tell it on the air. It's kind of funny. Two short...
I didn't know if you remembered this.
Oh, yeah. Two short, weird, flashy Middle Eastern guys, I think, used to come to the Comedy Cellar all the time. And they were just guys that were well-dressed for no reason at 2 in the morning at a comedy show.
Huge fans of yours. They're definitely listening to this right now.
That's great. They were great. They were sweet guys, I'm just saying, but they come up after
Middle
shows.
Middle Eastern guys.
It was guys that were, for Middle Eastern guys, they were cool. No, but they came up to me.
We were being racist earlier.
They came up to
new people in the studio, like, whoa.
They came up to me and they go, yo, man, Dustin Keller is a friend of ours. We want to bring him. We keep telling him about you. We want to bring him to a show. And I was like, yeah, dude, great. Didn't think that was going to be a real thing at all. And then they said it like 3 or 4 times and then just came with him one day. And I'm like, oh, shit, that was real. Still have no idea how he knew them or anything. I just became friends with you, like, separate from those guys.
I had met them that night.
There was really?
I had met them that night. There was a buddy of mine out of L.A. that he kind of does some promoting and stuff. And he said, yeah, I got some buddies. They said, this guy is the best damn comic there is. You got to check him out. I was like, okay. And I see him and, you know,
that's
I'm
hilarious.
Like, ah, I can't imagine me and these guys think the same thing's funny.
It was Tom Cotter.
They brought, that was like you were like set up on a Tinder date to go somewhere.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know about these guys. No, they were good dudes, but it was just such a weird grouping of people to be like, really? NFL tight end's going to come with you two weirdos?
Yeah.
Like, what are you guys going on, an international like sex slave yacht later or something? Why would they be hanging out together? But we became good buddies, man. And I came to watch you play a bunch. And then you went down to Miami.
Yeah.
You got picked up by the Dolphins.
Fan, man.
I remember,
unfortunately.
Tell you what, that is such the telltale of Money Talks. When I saw Dustin in Austin, you were getting ready to meet with the Dolphins.
Oh, yeah.
You were free agent, I think, from right? And he goes, I'm going to meet with the Dolphins. I go, oh, that's like the number one enemy with the Jets. He goes, I mean, I'm not going to sign with them, but I got to meet with everybody. And then the next day in the paper, the next day, he was like, Dustin Keller signed with the Dolphins. That must have been a hell of a meeting.
They sold me. They sold me. It didn't take much, but they sold me.
Do players even take Miami seriously? Or
yeah, they do. Actually, a good buddy of mine that just left the Patriots, Amendola.
Yeah,
he's
dude.
Over there.
Breaks my heart that he's the best player on our team right now. But I hate the Patriots with all my heart.
So. Yeah, you have to.
Yeah, it's been a long life being a Dolphin fan. We're pretty fucking terrible. That's 3-0 right now, and I'm not at all excited.
You're not happy at all. Just can't be satisfied.
Never.
Why don't you rebel against your dad and just not? Let him bequeath you that shit team for no reason. You have nowhere near
He's a
them.
Chiefs fan now.
He just switched?
Yeah.
Why would you take that man's word for anything?
I know, he left, right?
Who does that?
I don't know. Asked. Well, now I feel like a piece of shit changing teams at 38 years old. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
now I change
you
teams.
You can't do that. You can't
I can't
do that.
Just change teams.
You got to stick with the Dolphins.
For the rest
absolutely.
Of my fucking life.
Yeah. It sucks to have the reason be that, though. My dad liked the Dolphins that year, and then he moved on to somewhere else.
I say it's Dan Marino. That's what I say.
He cursed the whole squad?
Yeah. Well, no, that's the reason why I like him.
Oh, okay. But,
yeah, Marino's the man.
Yeah, never
he's
won anything.
He's doing fucking blow out in Pittsburgh.
Marino's with his isotoners.
Man,
yeah,
they're like, if we're going to Miami, he's like, jackpot. I'm gonna fucking die out here, dude.
Are you kidding me? Even I'm gonna kill it.
Even if Miami wins the Super Bowl, though, you're still not gonna be satisfied. When the Eagles won theirs, Jay was just like, okay, I got my victory, but now what?
Now
we need another one.
That's true.
That's exactly how I felt. One. I go, I don't know. Now what?
That's how you got to feel, man.
I don't know what to
that's
do.
That's how you
now.
Get rings.
True fan.
You felt better before you were winning.
Well, every year was like, now it's that energy that you have to do it. You look like assholes now.
Look like ass.
You look like ass.
You look like a bunch of bad asses.
We went to the first game this year, and no fights. That was pretty nice.
Yeah, that's what a ring will do.
Yeah.
Put a ring on it,
class
dude, everyone's
up the place.
Chilled out.
Well, they had an hour rain delay, which I thought was going to stir up some kind of something. But
what about when I tried to, through a third party, try to set you up with tickets?
Told that story so many times. Mark Sanchez, I gave him the biz on Philadelphia radio.
That's the worst story I've ever heard.
I'm going to tell us on Philadelphia radio. I did it on Preston Steve. I go, I want to make sure it gets back to him. How dare you? I've had my mom's friends come to a show and gotten them front row tickets for something. For not my shit, like an Amy Schumer something or whatever. And he goes, Dustin, it was so sweet too, because he goes, dude, Mark's my boy. We're still cool. Yeah, we're not on the team anymore, but he's still my boy. I'll get him to get you hooked up. He's your starting quarterback. And I go, this is going to be amazing. The feeling going from amazing to not amazing as we kept spiraling further and further up the steps.
You needed someone to hold your standing spot when you pissed.
Yes.
Oh,
to go
God.
To the bathroom, someone had to come stand in our spot, or else we'd lose our spot under the eye of the giant Miller Light sign, standing on the thing. I'm like, what? The long snapper brought us down to the locker room before.
Oh, man.
Off of a friend of a friend's father's hookup. Dustin Keller. Mark Sanchez has no respect for you. You should be the most hurt for this. You should be the one most hurt by this.
I am pissed. I'm going to call him right after the show. I kind of got over it, but you got me riled up again.
Yeah. He changed his number. He doesn't respect
us.
You
should fuck him up. You should fuck him up. I like Notre Dame. Fuck him up.
You went to Purdue, Indianapolis. They just shut the club down. Me and Mike have been out there together a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
Indianapolis. Odd town.
Real weird town.
I went to I did a webisode of the world's oldest bar there in Indianapolis, and it's just a bunch of drunk old fat guys who were telling you about where all the gunshots in the wall are from. Seems like an odd,
welcome to the Midwest.
Yeah, it is odd. Indianapolis is the first time I ever went there. There was an epidemic, they called it. Epidemic of people from the viral video of showing how cold it is outside. You could boil water.
Oh yeah.
Take it outside and throw it. And before it really leaves the pot, it'll evaporate, just kind of turns to dust almost, it looks like. Yeah. And they were being flooded in emergency rooms with people doing that as a prank, like boiling water, going outside, and you can see it's boiling, and like throwing it at their friend, but thinking it'll evaporate first. And it doesn't.
Yeah.
It'll hit the person's skin first. Man. So you just go to your friend and goes, hey, dude, think fast. He goes, no, dude, it's evaporating. Are you good?
I had a minor one of those, I gotta be honest. I was rehabbing my knee in Minnesota, and I saw that this is possible, and I went outside and kind of threw it away, and I saw, oh, damn, the water turned to snow. Okay, Aaron, get the video, I need to do an Instagram video. And I throw it up, and I think I just had too much water in there. It went up, and some of it turned, but then it came down and burnt the hell out of my back and everything else. So I'm one of those victims. I'm one of these YouTube videos.
Well, I'll tell you what. Christine took some shrapnel from a boiling
shit.
Meatball sauce. Oh,
oh
man. Fuck. The viral challenge.
Ooh. That's incredible.
You know what's funny? You always see those viral challenges that go right for the most part. Like the guy who sees if he could test his bulletproof vest. Like, go ahead and shoot. They only shoot the ones where he goes, that got through.
It's something that
got through.
It's
feeling
true.
That one.
Oh, God. It got through.
Did you grow up in the Midwest?
I did. I'm from Lafayette, Indiana, so right there near Purdue.
Wow.
Yeah.
Was that your first choice to play?
No, actually, I just wasn't very highly recruited out of high school. I actually committed to Toledo out of high school, and then Purdue offered the day before signing period, so I called them, declined, and...
You'd have been killing it with pussy in Toledo, Ohio. Let me tell you something. You'd be ringing in from Kentucky, Kentucky's finest.
Crossing the border.
All the teeth. The whole thing. Never committed a small felony. They're finest. They're finest people. Do you have a... Look up viral challenges gone bad in general. There's got to be so many.
Tide Pods are fucking great now.
Yeah.
Right?
What's that one?
People eating Tide Pods, those laundry detergent things. And it's like how many you can eat before you die, I think, right? Is that how fucking...
What?
I think it was like a meme first that was like, Tide Pods are delicious.
And then people started actually trying to eat them. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Pretty crazy.
Oh, wait, until you find that, Christine, can you bring up this video? We were watching, before you got here, American Idol auditions from back in the day that went bad.
Mm-hmm.
And we found this guy finally.
Oh.
I'm taken back by the guys who try to sing their way out the door. They keep thinking if they rip into one more...
It's going to save them.
And that's a shame. You feel that moment because as they're kicking you out, adrenaline's really going. It goes, this is my last chance. And there's just a visual already in your head of you being held sideways by security and Simon Cowell going, wait.
Just
let
once.
Him finish.
Release him.
Yeah, he goes, kiss from a rose.
That's the note. That's the one I was waiting for.
Yeah. I knew I had to help you get there.
Why are you holding out on me?
Play this guy. He's awesome. He does not want to stop singing songs.
Oh, wow.
You don't have to hear his background story. It doesn't matter. In front of Mary J. He's young. He's delusional. There.
There's a voice in there somewhere. You need to do a lot of work. I don't even know.
Yeah, go back to his singing.
Like Dwight Freeney.
By the way, why I found this one so interesting, I thought he was doing all right.
Yeah, but it goes downhill pretty quick.
To the layman?
Baby, I could pay you to a kiss from a rose on the grave. Ooh, the more I hear of you, the stranger it is, yeah. Now that you're
I don't get the DJ scratch.
I like love it. On the grave.
Oh.
I get it, though. If I was his friend, I'd be like, damn, that was fucking
Your first word is like, mother.
I'll drive you there, dude.
You go, where was that, Lamar? Where did that come
that
from?
That was a mix between.
Out Oki, bro.
You got to know. I'm done. Just some guy. That was a mix between Fergie and Jesus.
Yo, dog. I got to say, dude. Your shit's beat.
I mean, imagine getting high and that guy hitting that. Oh. Hitting that fucking, those vocals.
I'd be like, yo,
hold
real,
smoke
dude.
In your mouth and nodding. Go, for real.
That's fucking good.
Good, dude.
Yo, I'm going online right now and signing you up.
Go, now you're getting the judging when he does not believe.
You're watching TV and he's on and you're like, oh, fuck. I kind of did this.
Ooh, I might have set Lamar up for that. He went through, huh? He really waited 3 hours. Wow.
Lamar, man, I got mad love for you, man, but that was kind of torturous, man. I mean, the pitch was all over the place. It was like, I don't know.
Song for you?
Yeah, here it goes.
No, it's not that, man. I just don't think you're that good, man.
Like, sweetie?
Yeah, Lamar,
you know,
dude.
You're 19 man. Years old.
I'm 20.
Okay, 20. I'm not going to say that you're a terrible singer because you're
I'm
not.
I'm really shocked
because
that's not true.
But
that's
hold
not
on,
true.
I'm not going to say that. I'm not going to say that.
Dog, are you a good listener?
I am a very good listener.
Okay, so listen to us for a second. It wasn't great. There's a voice in there somewhere. You need to do a lot of work. I don't even know if you really, for this level. No, don't. Yeah,
that's the best.
Listen, I asked if you were going to
wait, pause it. That's my favorite. I know it's a visual, but you have to watch it. At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter and Instagram. He goes, la, la, la.
Yo, stop.
It's like his mouth just goes,
please help.
Go back to that.
Don't do this to me on TV.
Shit. No, don't. Honey, don't say anything else. Stop. Listen, I asked if you
were good. That was pretty good.
Can you just shut the camera off?
And I asked if you were good. Listen, you keep singing.
I am.
Lamar, let me tell you something. Lamar, let me give you one little bit of advice.
I really do sing.
Lamar, hold on.
I want to just share something with you. You have to find some humility in order to do this and pull back and stop. Listen, and stop trying to exalt yourself. And that's what you're doing. You're running.
So just
you need to do the
relax.
Work, sweetheart. You haven't done the work yet. So let's take a vote.
Lamar.
No.
Lamar.
No, wait, but that's not it.
No.
He keeps going.
You're passionate. But see, you're not even listening. Dog, what are you doing?
There's
dog.
Nothing better than that,
that the f-
Hey, yes. Fuck y'all. Yes. Wait.
I don't understand. I really don't understand.
Lamar, listen.
I mean,
listen,
y'all
please.
Telling me basically I can't sing. That's
no, we
ins-
said
that's
you
have
insane. Insult to nobody
me.
Said you couldn't
nobody
sing.
Said that.
Not
nobody
one
said that.
Nobody said that.
It wasn't great today, dog. You're not ready for this level. We're trying to find the
are
best.
Yes.
We're trying to find the best. You
we're
weren't the best.
We're trying to help you here, honey. We're not trying to hurt you.
This is crazy.
Honey, right off the bat.
He's got my phone.
They got bouncers got to come.
Bring in Steve.
He's like, yeah, shut up. Stop singing in my face.
Don't call that vibrato, dog.
Stop singing in my mouth.
Oh,
really?
That is not
it is funny when they get like, whoa, you cursed that ass? Like, you just called him a piece of shit for 15 minutes. He gave you your TV. Let him call you a bitch. You have the girl with the green dress on. That's the other one we had to get, too, which was also just great. I like when they wait in line for 20 hours, whatever it is. They get in there and they go, you're not good. They go, your opinion don't mean shit. They're just waiting 20 hours for it.
I don't need you to tell me I'm good.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do.
I'm not looking for your validation. You are only looking for my validation. It's solely what you came here for. Do you have her?
We did the girl in the green dress.
No. No, no, no.
Yeah, look.
No, that's not her. Not her.
Oh.
Another green dress. It might be before this all. Might be earlier on.
No, it's not in this video.
All right, you can find it. You see the girl in the green dress and crate? You'll know who it is. She has a crazy face. It's in all the bad ones. You'll see, yeah. When those nutty eyes walk in, dude, belief in talent that you don't have, it has to be unbelievable. I'm always way underestimated myself to save myself from looking like an asshole.
No, I'm the best. I'm the fucking best.
But I've never looked at anybody in anything and went, no. I'm really, really good at this.
Yeah, you're going to want to stay.
Eating pussy, but all fat guys say that.
For a white guy, you're good at eating pussy.
That's your fucking, that's your buy-in to the poker game. You go, I'm really, really good at eating pussy. So now, let me tell you some of the things I do. I can dance. I have a couple bucks.
It's got to feel that way going into, like, waiting to be drafted. That's got to be fucking.
Oh, yeah. Well, especially for the guys that show up. I guess they don't have it at Radio City anymore, but they show up for the actual draft itself. So I thought that there was a chance that I was going to be a first-round pick, but there was no way in hell that I was going to show up at the draft. You've seen too many times before the guys that thought they were going to be the top two picks. What Brady year? Quinn sitting
yeah,
there.
Brady yeah, Brady Quinn. Yeah. Yeah.
Showing a counter to you, and you're still going like,
oh, my gosh.
Still here. I'm hanging in.
And they just the camera's right there in your face, 2 inches from you, and people are looking like, ah, oh, damn.
And they're rubbing your mom's rubbing your back.
It's like, yeah.
Yeah. It's like, I'm fucking fine. Get off.
You get drafted.
High school jersey's ready at any moment.
You get drafted 22nd overall, and you can't even enjoy this shit. It was the most miserable thing you've ever done in your life. I couldn't do anything like that. I was at Purdue in our press box watching the draft. Nice. No cameras there to embarrass the hell
no
out of
cameras.
Me. No cameras.
That's pre-social media, too.
Oh, yeah. Social media. It would have destroyed a lot of people.
That's a long Instagram story.
Oh, man. Oh,
damn, Brady Quinn's really was rough. Because then it was like, we got a phone call. It's like, finally. It's like, it's the fucking Browns.
Shit.
Son of a bitch.
Can you
make
up?
It any worse? Hey, you got to find out you were moving to New York. That's not bad. That's a pretty good one. That's fun.
No, it was awesome. It was awesome. Came to New York and then spent a little bit of time. Obviously, training camp. I hurt my knee in Miami, but... Not
fucking
two awesome cities.
I blame the Dolphins for that.
Yeah.
Who'd you like growing up? Who was your team?
I was a Colts fan, being from Indiana. Loved Peyton Manning. It's incredible watching him play the game. And he has the fans so coached up. You go to one of those games, he sits there and he, you know, waves his hands down for the fans to shut up, and everybody is quiet. And then you're on the sideline on the other team, you're like, holy shit, did he really just quiet down the whole crowd? And then somebody in the crowd will hear you like, hey, show some damn respect for Peyton. Shut up. It was crazy.
That's nuts.
Show some respect for him. That's cool. Andrew Luck is just, I mean, they kept the legacy of ugly quarterback, but he looks doofy as all hell, Andrew Luck.
Yeah.
Bring up a picture of Andrew Luck. And put an Andrew Luck looking at his best in the Google. I want to show you how the only amount you can polish up this turd.
Oh my God.
God damn it.
Handsome.
Yeah. He looks like a cult.
He goes, all right, guys, Baby Ruth on three. Baby Ruth? Baby Ruth. Yeah, man. He's got the face of a fucking middle linebacker.
But you know what? You look at a lot of those quarterbacks when they first got in the league, they're like, ooh, man, that guy came in pretty rough. And then they get paid, they make some money, they figure it out. But some people don't.
Tom Straight Brady? Up to me, Nick Foles went from looking like Napoleon Dynamite to mad fuckable to me.
To you.
To this old sailor.
Yeah. You're right, Tom Brady, too. He came into the league first.
Goofy looking.
Tom Brady's combine picture is fucking insane.
Have you
ever seen it?
Is it goofy looking?
Yeah, and this is back like pre-Under Armour, so he was wearing like baggy, weird gym shorts. It's fucking
like
weird.
Russell Athletic.
Pre-Giselle.
Some champions.
Pre-Giselle.
His combine picture?
Yeah.
That is hilarious.
How it's taking him through the years?
Oh my God.
How hot he got.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That was a different human being.
Yeah.
Jesus. He looked like when Kevin Nealon would do Frankenstein on Saturday Night Live.
I think he got new teeth.
Oh.
What year? Yeah.
That was the year.
Sounds like a great idea. Everyone's coming down on me. Yeah, he is. Carson Wentz, that's what I said. Carson Wentz came back in this week and had two amazing drives with fucking pimples all over his neck. It was beautiful. He doesn't have to be good. He's played good enough to make Christine think he's fuckable. He's all about Carson Wentz.
Yeah.
She'll pop his back zits. She don't give a fuck. She'll fucking grab on that freckly back. Take a ride.
This crazy fucking
bitch. Is this
bitch.
The girl you're talking about, Jay?
This is. Let's take our last break and we'll come back and talk to her. Because you could already tell by that face that, one, yes, we would all and probably have all fucked her.
I give her 8 songs already.
She's 8 songs in.
8 songs.
Because she doesn't look great, but she's going to do weird stuff without you having to ask. And that's always nice. We're hanging out with Dustin Keller, Mike Fenoya, Shane Gillis, Comedy Central Radio Series XM 95, Big J Okerson. Sitting in for Dan Soder today, we have Mike Fenoya, Shane Gillis, our guest hanging out, Dustin Keller. Thank you guys all for coming in. It's been a fucking fun show so far.
Yeah, dude.
You said this is the first time you're hearing this, Dustin. You didn't hear the whole back and forth. Machine Gun Kelly versus Eminem. It's I thought Machine Gun Kelly won at first, and then Eminem came back big.
You should hear it when Fish and the Grateful Dead go at it, like jam wars. It's pretty crazy, man. Dude. Shit gets fucking close.
73-minute diss track.
Certain people you shouldn't ever try.
Eminem's probably one of them. Yeah,
he's one of them.
But you said it's like he went back 20 years when he did this comeback. So.
Yeah, I haven't been into his new stuff too much, but you know, whatever. Dave Smith said yesterday on Legion of Skanks, it really rap is a younger man's game. You're not really supposed to be an old timey. I mean, like when you watch him, like fucking wheelbarrow out the Sugar Hill Gang or something, now to do something.
Yeah, right.
Fat Run DMC and shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, I think what happens, you get older and you realize you're not going to get a mansion and a bunch of bitches. And then it's just like, all right, well, quit bragging. I'm going to work. It's also my office.
But when you have all this stuff, though, too, it's hard to stay hungry. That's why I said, I think young, poor people make good music. When you first start to get money, you can still make good music because you're hungry to kind of keep that thing. But a comfortable, wealthy,
clean and sober,
sober 45-year-old,
yeah, sobriety kills.
Don't happen.
Sobriety kills good music.
It's the same exact
hanging
thing.
Hanging out by my fireplace with a large but not crazy-sized television.
A reasonably priced mid-sized sedan.
An Audi, but you know, with roll-down windows.
It's just like players, they always have, they're doing okay, bad season, but then when it's contract time, best season of their life. Best season of their life.
Yeah, every one-handed catch you go for? Yeah. Because I'm laying my body out for this.
Yeah.
I tell Mike downstairs that was one of the most interesting perspectives to have on us. You got blindsided by Ray Lewis, and me and you were friends already at that point, and it was the first time I ever felt that. I become friends with a couple UFC fighters now over time, and watching that same thing, when you have a stake in the game, and Aaron, your lovely wife, is here. I sat with her at a game before when, you know, you were down for a second and pop back up, but just what an emotional roller coaster if you know somebody in it. Like, he's down. He goes, oh, he's down. It's like, nope, he's okay. Okay, everything's fine.
Yeah. Wait, Ray Lewis got you?
Holding a hot dog and being sad for a second.
Gives Jerry Maguire a whole new meaning.
I guess you could say this is another Sanchez story. You know, I ran a little slant route right at an NFL legend. I didn't think the ball was coming my way. It came.
Oh, it came.
Who was the quarterback? Across the middle goes, I'm decoy. Oh,
was that Sanchez?
That was my buddy Sanchez.
No, he fucking got you killed.
Fuck that dude, man.
It was, but I remember you came to the comic strip one night, and I was like, dude, I got to ask you. And I go, the impressive part of it all, I prefaced with, you were back the next play. I think you were out the one play, and then just came the next play. But it was such a vicious hit, and he was right back, held onto the ball, didn't drop the ball and everything. I was like, that was great. And he was like, it wasn't that bad. I go, nah, man. Come on, it's Ray Lewis. This guy's a murderer.
He's taking lives.
Guy's literally beat murder. Like, he's playing with the aggression that every day is a gift. Yeah. And he hit you blindside. I go, what was it like? And he goes, it looked worse than it was. I go, come on, man. And he just went, it was a good hit. It was fine.
You know what's so funny is the next year and the year after that and the year after that, every year in training camp, every team has an official that comes into the locker room and goes over the New Year's rules. This is an illegal hit. This is an illegal hit. This right here is your example of your ideal hit. And I became the damn poster boy for the best hit.
Shit.
Everybody, all my teammates, I'm sitting there just hunched down. Everybody's like, damn, DK. You're going to be on Ray Ray's highlight reel for the rest of your life.
And the guy's like, look at the beauty of that. Perfect timing.
Just amazing.
Everything wrapped. Shoulder pads right below his shoulder pads. Body crumbled up into a ball.
Just a man dominating another man. Look at that.
You're eating a protein bar. Like, it was fine. It's fine. It's football, man. Whatever. It was on that fateful day. Soder's the frozen tundra. The frozen tundra of Meadowlands.
When men become giants. Smash. Dude, the next day, you're done, huh?
After a game? No. Honestly, it looked a lot worse than
not
it really
just
was.
That, not just that hit.
Oh,
but
yeah. So the next day, you have a little workout that's not too much, and we have to kind of jog some hundreds, 100 yards. And your body just beat the hell down. You're sitting there, and it's like laughable. You're like, well, hopefully I can pull off another 10 years of this.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
But you get through it. I don't know.
Yeah, training camp must it all comes together the first time you're in front of the crowd and stuff, I assume. It's got to be unlike anything.
Dude,
the reaction of something you do, just setting a place off like that, it's got to be comedy will never. Well, I guess Kevin Hart figured that out somehow, but the rest of us won't. Football stadium comedy? I don't know if I'm made for it.
I think I told you.
Look at this asshole in the front row. It's binoculars. The 700 level of the other side of the football field. Intimate comedy at Lincoln Financial Stadium.
It's open mic night. I stood on the sidelines at a Pats Dolphins game, and Zach Thomas put a hit on Bledsoe. Mm-hmm. And it was just the sound of a professional football hit was fucking, it sounded like a car accident, you know? And it's just so wild to like, they would get up right after the play and just shake it off, go into the huddle, and I'm just like, Jesus fucking Christ, like, that's insane.
Are you still in front of the TV every Sunday?
Honestly, no.
No?
And that, when you text me about doing this and I was a little bit hesitant, my biggest hesitation was, you asking me too many football questions and me having no damn clue what you're talking about.
It's a comedy show. You don't know anything about sports. I watch American Idol auditions all day. I don't give a shit.
We're just making people laugh when they drive home from work.
You'd be surprised how much they appreciate it.
I would guess that everybody in this room right now watches a little bit more football than I do.
I just watch the Eagles. I just watch one team every week. And then I watch like parts of a game of teams I want to see lose, the Giants. I don't even have to watch to know the Cowboys aren't going to pull it out, Black Lou. Wow.
Yeah.
Well, they're having a rough go.
Yeah.
Well, look, Dak Prescott came in here. He was very handsome.
That's the thing I love about college.
Yeah, something nice.
That's the thing I love about college football. It's on every night now. You can watch any game.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter who it is. It's just fun. That's the beauty of being a Dolphin fan, is you learn to just watch games for the sake of the game.
Yeah.
You're never in it. It doesn't matter.
I enjoy the way it's played.
Just watch it for big hits.
I don't know if you saw they changed... They're changing rules to something I really don't understand. That Clay Matthews came through and got 3 sacks on, who was Alex Smith in the Redskins game? 3 clean, Alex Smith holding the ball still when he hits the ground. They threw flag roughing the passer all three times. You can't sack a quarterback. I don't know what the call is. That makes no sense. Can you bring a footage of that, Christine, at all? Someone took a break over there. We're talking football. Like, well, we can't get NFL licensing. What can we bring up?
Do you keep in touch with a bunch of the guys you used to play with?
I do. I try to. You know, as much as you can. My days are filled up mostly with the kids, and that's probably why I don't see so much football, because they don't give a damn about football.
Sure.
Nice. They couldn't care less. It's on the TV. It's like, ugh, Mickey Mouse.
Nice.
Mickey Mouse Clubhouse.
It's way safer.
They don't care about the memorabilia or anything yet of your stuff and everything and the stories.
They don't give a damn.
You got such a better story than 4 touchdowns in 1 game. Your Al Bundy story is so much better.
They don't give a shit about Ray Lewis.
I walked away from it from Ray Lewis. And they're going to go, yeah, Dad, great. You go, son, he was a murderer. This guy killed somebody after a Super Bowl win. You look at me when I'm talking to you. I don't understand what I'm telling you. That's been. Do you have that, the Clay Matthews hits?
I think I have it right here. Sorry.
I think I say not late or anything.
The option. I used to get in a lot of trouble, got excluded a few times.
Hey, can you turn off this Indian guy giving a dissertation on something? Thank
you. That's about the new iPhone.
And I want to see, is there a helmet?
I couldn't guess what they're calling, but they didn't. It wasn't even.
Oh, that's terrible.
It's completely
right
clean.
Did they say he lowered his head? Screen.
I don't know. Yeah, I have no idea.
Not even.
He put his helmet to the side.
See, is there helmet contact?
That was
here?
Better than Ray's hit.
The helmet hits his shoulder. And that's what it is.
I bet Alex Smith hurt worse than
it's
I did.
So fucking ridiculous, man. It's so stupid.
It's going to become a flag.
It's going to become a thing where basically people are going to get hurt trying to avoid hits. You know what I'm saying?
Would you let your kids play?
If my son asked me my true opinion, I'd be like, for what? Go play basketball and baseball.
Go make love to women.
Yeah.
Yeah. He goes, kid, do whatever you want. Just not football and no dancing.
So I live in Texas now, so if he wants to play football, he can play football.
He's playing football.
That'd be ridiculous for me to tell him he can't play a sport that I played.
Sure.
But if he asks my opinion, I'd be like, basketball's pretty cool.
Yeah, baseball, dude. Baseball's the way to go.
Yeah.
That's so boring.
Exactly. No. You have a 45-year career.
No, basketball. You're right. Basketball. Basketball moves quick. You don't want to sit there. God forbid he's good at baseball. And you got to go, like, oh, great. We're going to the States. Oh, there's another tournament. We have to watch 9 innings of children play ball.
Down in Texas, it's probably year-round.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I go to 3 of my daughter's soccer games a year. After every one, I feel like I've died a little bit inside.
I went to one of her basketball games. I'm fucking dying still.
I'll never get those hours of my life back. And nothing happens.
I still go to kids' games.
I've never seen her score a goal.
I hang out at kids' soccer games. I think they're great.
They call you Skip.
I look like Gritty. I look like a Flyers mascot in every fucking
Gritty is
game.
The best mascot in the fucking world.
Oh, bring
dude.
Up the fly in the new Flyers mascot.
This guy is every bad acid trip in a puppet. I
and
love
we have
so
to get
much.
To that girl.
Oh my god.
It's the greatest thing in the world.
What the fuck?
Look at Gritty, dude.
Oh, hey everyone, wow. From your nightmares comes the Philadelphia Flyers mascot. Inspired by a David Lynch dream.
I love this thing.
This like, little ditty. Look at its face.
Like Elmo with a beard.
Yeah, there's videos of him just fucking getting down.
I said it looks like the inbred child of the piano player from the Muppet Band and Animal.
It looks like
the drummer.
Yeah. Looks like part Dave Mustaine. Part pumpkin.
Yeah, the eyes are all fucked up.
Yeah, he's on fucking tons
Hooray.
Of Faygo.
That's the new mascot for the Philadelphia Flyers.
Dude, I'm
you
shaking
may
his
want
dick.
By the way, I like the he's
grandfather clock in the NHL.
He's just a fat ginger from Kensington.
Yeah,
yeah, Google eyed because he's hammered already. Let's climb a pole.
That guy's great.
Beer belly.
It's not
Gritty's,
a good look.
Gritty's fucking
gross.
Great.
It's
it
awesome.
It's disturbing.
I can't believe that I was actually introduced to somebody and they said,
I want to know
perfect.
What lost. Yeah,
like,
I want to know what
I know,
lost
that
to Gritty.
Meeting.
You can probably find out. Oh, is this him coming out for the first time?
He's
this
like,
kid's
waka,
scared.
Waka.
Show a bunch of kids, parents hugging their children. No, he only stays on the ice. You want me to come up into the stands with my sharp feet? No. Gritty.
Hide this knife for Gritty.
If anyone asks, you were with Gritty last night from 8 till 2 in the morning.
Gritty was tutoring you last night. Not fucking your mother.
You come out of your bedroom and see Gritty's mask on the couch. Mama!
Not Gritty. Gritty's your dad now.
sit on my front ass.
Who was it? Langston Kerman called in yesterday. He's got a half hour special coming out. Comedy Central this Friday.
Funny, dude.
He called in. His mom used
Look
to
gritty,
get.
Fucking gritty eating shit on
his
the
His mom
ice.
Used to get nailed by Benny the Bull, the Chicago Bulls mascot.
Really?
Damn. That's got to be great. Just having a guy bitching at the house that, like, mad at your mom because dinner's not ready, and he's got, like, the suspenders connected to a giant bottom. So he goes, I fucking come home from busting my ass trampoline dunking all day. I can't have a fucking warm meal. Hey, kid, what are you doing? Comedy still, you clown? Fuck out of here.
Can you get Scottie Pippen to sign this for me? When you're done fucking my mom? Dude, that's just such a great...
Your mom's... Oh, my God. The guy's got a butt in his mouth, and he goes... Look, kid, I don't want to be your dad. I just want you to respect me as a friend. And then just puts the fucking Benny the Bullhead on. I'll see you after work.
Hey, get the door for me?
Hey, clean the house. Don't be an asshole to your mom, huh? Clean your room. Don't be an asshole. They already got stickers, huh?
Oh, they have everything.
This is the design.
What is it? It's a ginger werewolf? The Philadelphia ginger werewolf?
Yeah.
Dude. He's yelling at Twitter, Gritty. He's like, it's the guy that gives out the blue checks got a day off today. He's just an angry
He's already
drunk.
Talking shit?
Yeah, it's great.
That'd be sick if they gave it to some junkie from Kensington. Twitter for Gritty? He's like, yay. Yay. Wait.
It's four dudes running the
lane. Yeah, he's doing the blue checks out here.
Dude, Gritty.
I want to get a blue check.
Gritty's amazing.
I can never get into hockey.
But it's the best video game in the world.
It's a very fun video game.
It's awesome in person, though.
Yeah.
I keep hearing it's great. You have to go.
A few years ago, I went to a Rangers and New Jersey Devils game, playoff game.
Mm. 1-0.
Awesome.
Great seats, I bet, awesome. Too, huh?
They were pretty good.
Yeah. That's the best.
You follow basketball at all?
I do.
Who's your team there, Pacers?
Gosh. I'm actually a Lakers fan. And I was a Lakers fan well before LeBron made this jump. But
well, yeah,
not that.
That's probably not a good.
Not
thing.
That it's been real tough being a Lakers fan, you know.
It's been all right. Yeah, you like a Lonzo okay Ball fan?
I don't know, man. I don't know. I think his.
I'm a fan. I'm
you
a
like fan. You like the family?
I love the fucking dad.
You're
dad
a fan of the
fucking.
I can't
hilarious.
Wait for the TV show.
The cat. What's the
having a
Kenan
ball.
Thompson doing it on SNL is the funniest thing ever. The dad.
Oh my god! I never.
When he said he started his own basketball league, he goes, "We will be traveling by a bus." Called Peter Pan. He was staying at a motel so super, they call it 8. He goes,
here he is.
Continental breakfast, frosted mini wheats. Is this it?
How you doing, Colin? Me? I'm doing incredible. I got one son in the NBA and two on the way. I'm like Earl Woods, Joe Jackson, and Dina Lohan all rolled into one.
He's just black Never Donald lost. Trump. LeVar Ball is just black Donald Trump.
Oh, yeah.
Like this week, you said that you could beat Michael Jordan in basketball with one arm tied behind your back.
You damn right. While wearing a beekeeper suit and hamburger helper gloves.
Now, how can you say that?
You can stop it. It's, you can check that out. We'll put it out on at the Bonfire SXM.
I'd love if he would just like crash like post game.
Oh, just doing
like,
a character.
Just pop up. No, fucking actual dad.
I'm a huge Sixers fan. Ben Simmons. Christine, update? Still dating Kendall Jenner?
I don't know.
I hope not.
Private.
I hope she broke his heart and he plays with that fire. I don't want a stupid Kardashian. What did we watch? Was that me and you, Mikey, this weekend? We watched Caitlyn Jenner on something?
Yeah.
Ellen DeGeneres. So it was like moments people got mad at her on Ellen DeGeneres.
Yeah.
Tell you what, I realize maybe I do it on purpose. I have not looked into the face of Caitlyn Jenner a ton. It's disturbing. That might be a popular yeah. thing to say. It's not disturbing even that. I think if I just met her, I'd be like, oh, that's like an odd-looking woman. But now it looks like Bruce Jenner grew his hair out and got tits, and it's weird.
It really is.
I think like, that's I know exactly the, what
I know,
happened.
I know, yeah.
That's exactly what
But
happened.
I know the early product. If someone just introduced you, this is my friend Caitlin, you'd be like, that's one big bitch, and I don't know, unfuckable, maybe on the late night.
What are you doing, dude?
Hmm?
He's brave. What are you thinking? Look at that. It's jacked fucking lady.
Yeah, what was it that she was getting upset with? Fucking,
No, Ellen DeGeneres was mad at her because she's transgender
still
and still says gay marriage
yeah.
is
yeah, she's trans-
stupid.
She's like, gay people shouldn't get married. Like, well, all right, yeah. Take it easy, Caitlin.
Yeah.
They're taking up all the good men, those homos. Yeah.
So fucking weird.
You wiener biters are taking up all the good men, and us ladies are out here. Still together?
It says it's dying down.
Yeah, get you some, Ben Simmons.
So Kendall isn't looking for anything serious.
Good. Dunk that dork all summer long, then show up at camp.
I wonder if that's how he found out. article, like it's reportedly dying down. What the fuck?
That's rough.
Hey, mate.
I love you, you bitch. You fucking bitch. I love you, dude. I'll fucking kill you. I'm reading fucking bizarre articles out here, you fucking bitch.
That was new for him, too. He was like walking out of clubs now, like the cameras follow him the whole way. You know what I mean? He was like a. He was an unproven rookie last year, and now he's got Kardashian heat on him. That's got to just stink. But they kill NBA players, those girls. James Harden did all right. But if it ain't James Harden staying on track, the rest of them are just fucking having a stroke from fake dick pills in a goddamn brothel.
Which one was James Harden?
Chris Humphreys is fucking making pasta sauce for his friends in fucking New Jersey somewhere.
Slice of garlic.
I mean, they tear through him. Tristan Thompson, next thing you know, he's fingering chicks in some Miami club somewhere. That's on TMZ. Nobody would have cared. Tristan Thompson. They make them famous NBA players from being role players, and they just make them pieces of shit nobodies.
I don't know if he's like,
you know what? It's good not to be a LeBron or a Kobe. I just get delayed back in the cut, finger chicks in a Miami lounge. Shit's going all right. I'm doing okay. Yeah, and then you got TMZ looking at you. Well, look who was fingering in a Miami. They were putting their pussies on my fingers.
What am I supposed to do?
It's rude to move them.
Oh, we got caught cheating again.
Who?
Tristan Thompson.
Really? Is there a video?
I hope so.
Is that them?
Jesus.
Well, I mean, when Thunder he left the house, she should have known he was going somewhere weird.
No, that's her.
Oh. I thought Timmy goes, "Hon, I'm going to head out of the house." Tristan, are you dressed like a barbarian? Yeah. Yeah, it's like a thing we're doing in practice now.
Yeah. It's going to the Thunderdome.
We're Game of Thrones in it now at work. What do you do this time?
I don't know. It says there's a video. I didn't even know this happened.
Well, is there a video?
I'm looking.
No, dude, you got it exactly right. That's what happens. It's not like the Kardashians do this or the Jenners do this to these people. It's just like all of a sudden there's cameras falling around fucking NBA players.
There's a circus around
here. Of course they're going to film some fucked up shit, dude.
Yeah. He goes, is that a third string shooting guard found playing Russian roulette in fancy Las Vegas hotel room? I'm like, what? And the showman goes, anything for you, Kendall. Pink.
Still here.
Dude. You see that shit? You see what I'm fucking doing for you, Kendall? I'm gonna fucking spit it. Put another bullet in there, dude. I fucking love you.
That's my beautiful.
Because first thing you know, you're on a date. You're going to Craig's in L.A., and then before you know, you're holding her hostage in a hotel room, making demands for shit you can't get.
Helicopter, get it here.
On the roof, right now, where baby Kendall gets it. Oh, man. I'm happy their thing's dying. Did you find a video, Christine?
I think so.
Is it too graphic because we have company?
I love that video of that dolphin coach blowing lines.
Oh, that was the best.
Isn't that one of the fucking...
That is the best.
So fucking awesome.
Was he there when you were there? No, he wasn't. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
That was great. Was,
this table doesn't lines smell as good as your snatch.
Off your pussy. I wish I was doing this. Off your pussy.
Was that the O-line coach?
Yeah, dude.
I think you can attest to this. O-line coaches are the best coaches on every team.
Oh, yeah.
They're always the coolest, funniest fucking guys.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, this guy sounds like a party.
Off your pussy.
This guy's up right off
I wish I was looking this. Off your pussy.
Miami Dolphins. My team.
It's so great.
Fins up.
Oh, how you doing?
Off your pussy.
Oh, that surface that... let's just play the video. What happens is Tristan is leaving a club, but two
dude,
girls...
Dude, there has to be nothing worse...
Okay. ...than working with Wendy
being
Williams?
A dude, no, than being a dude, and you get caught fucking up, and you're so angry at the world, you got caught, you know you fucked up, you got guilt, you're angry, people are angry at you, and then you look up, and there's just some gay guy in a suit going, sister, is Tristan Thompson getting tough turkey or what out there? And you're like, you fucking piece of shit. Oh, you fucking...
Let's watch it again.
He's the only one yelling at you that you can hit?
Yeah.
You feel like, ooh, I wish I was in that room.
That's such fucking... brutal
for
dude.
Him
how okay. Can you believe this guy and she's so beautiful
Hurricane Tristan
One of his crew says, hey, hang to the side.
Uh-huh.
Like, send them out.
Tristan
early.
Comes out.
There he is in the stripe.
Yes, he gets into his car.
Uh-huh.
And the two girls are facing the wall like they're being arrested.
Right?
I don't know what's going on.
Oh. Right?
He gets into his car.
He don't let his bitches look at him.
Into another car.
Oh, my God.
And both cars drive off.
And where do they drive?
Well, here's the thing. Nobody knows where they drove.
Can I say something positive? He's going to get a lot of shit now, but can I give him something positive? You got to be a bad motherfucker to pick up those two chicks in a sweatsuit.
Yeah.
And be like, yo, go outside, get out of this alley, and stare at the fucking wall.
Don't
like
look
Blair
at me.
Witch, dude.
Put your
don't
nose in the corner.
That's yeah, what I want. That's the shape it. I want to get into. If somebody, if I have a trainer who asks, what kind of shape you want to get into? I go, pick up pussy and sweatpants hot.
That's a pretty sick goal. That's a good actual
like,
goal.
Right,
you said that as a joke, and I was like, that's actually
if you give me, like. If you give me 12 to 16 weeks, we can get you there.
Oh, man, if I could just go commando dick swinging in the breakaway pants.
Just grandfather.
And when
clock.
I walk, you see it like bouncing in the pants. And then she goes, what's that? I go, let's find out. I just fucking magic mic it off.
And just metronome some pussy.
Come on, man. All day, every day. Guys, thank you. This show flew by, man. Thank you guys so much for coming. And Dustin, so cool to have you here,
yeah,
man.
Thanks for having me.
I know you're only in town for a couple nights, right?
Yeah.
Fucking anything you want to plug in going on? Business stuff? Anything you want to shout out there?
Today's actually my birthday.
Happy birthday, dude.
I came in town for my
we're
birthday.
We're prepared.
No shit. Yeah.
Oh, dude,
happy
we know
birthday,
tranny
man.
Porn
thank
stars.
You.
We've done something hilarious. happy birthday, man. I fucking love you. Great to see you.
Good seeing you.
Shane Gillis this weekend, everybody. Don't forget, we'll play the American Idol thing. We'll do it tomorrow. We have some fun guests coming in tomorrow. Can I tell them who?
Yep.
Tomorrow we have coming in, we have David Tell and Mike Vecchione, everybody. It's going to be a
wow.
fun fucking day.
That's a good show.
Fuck. Shane Gillis this Saturday.
I feel like I'm losing to the Poodles. Oh, you got that one next?
Yes, Poodles.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, well, thanks. We were Tom Cotter, everybody. Yeah.
Shane Gillis is going to be this weekend, this Saturday, at the House of Blues in Boston. For tickets, go to houseofblues.com/Boston. He's bringing the hot 23-year-old girlfriend with him. So
yeah.
You know, take a peek.
Yo, go see Baby Girl. Dude.
Yo, go see Baby Girl. Best of the Bonfire, don't forget. Best of the Bonfire available as a podcast. The same show that airs on SiriusXM on Fridays, available now as a podcast. You can download it on Apple or wherever you download podcasts from. Please do it. Rate, review, let people know you're listening. Let's get our numbers so we can keep this show moving forward and building. We want to do that for you guys also. Mike Fenoya is going to be Christine at the Fairfield Comedy Club in Connecticut, October 27th. For tickets, to check out his new for tickets to that and to check out his new podcast Amigos on the and I Osiris Network.
Osiris Network.
On the Osiris Network. Visit MikeFenoya.com. Soder at the Funny Bone in Omaha, September 27th through the 29th. He's going to be at Santa Ana Star Casino, New Mexico with Shane Gillis, October 5th. 191 Tool in Tucson. Are you going to be there too?
Yep.
So the whole Arizona thing. In Tucson, October 6th, and Tempe Improv in Arizona. Shane Gillis on all of those. That's October 5th through the 7th. For tickets and all the tour dates, go to dansoder.com. For my dates, everyone, most important right now, get to Calgary this weekend. I'll be in Calgary. Yuck Yucks. Make sure you get tickets for that and all my shows, bigjcomedy.com. And I love you guys. Thank you guys
happy
all so
birthday,
much for hanging
dude.
Out, man. Happy
appreciate
birthday,
it, man.
Dustin Keller. From me, Dan, and the whole Bonfire crew. We'll catch you tomorrow. Crackle, crackle.
Naughty pussy.